Hey, what's going on, guys? It's Tekosaur. With the Ryzen 9000 CPUs on the horizon, I thought I'd revisit my current Ryzen 7950X 3D and check what features and improvements have been released to the latest BIOS versions on the MSI X670E Ace motherboard. The BIOS version I'll be using is the latest as of 1st of August 2024. You can see in the note it says here it has some features intended for Ryzen 9000 CPUs like the curve shaper, as well as memory OPP and OCOTF. Now, I'm not sure what memory OCOTF could mean. I checked online and found no matches, but it may be memory overclocking on the fly. I'm not really sure. Please let me know in the comment if you know the answer. But as for memory OPP, it stands for Memory Optimized Platform Profile. So at the end, they are both intended for memory overclocking and optimization profiles. With all said, I'm going to compare this new BIOS version in terms of new changes and improvements against the one from 2023 to see what has changed over the course of a year, and also to give you an update about my latest settings on the Ryzen 7000 series. Again, the motherboard I'll be using is the MSI MAG X670E Ace, a true beast I must say after using it for almost 2 years. As for RAM memory, I'll be using Zscaler Radeon Z5 Neo at 6000 MTS speed. I have in total 4 sticks installed for a total of 64GB. This memory setup is 100% Expo AMD compatible and has given me no issues since day one. With that being said, let's get started first by going to the Settings tab, and then Advanced, AMD Overclocking, DDR and Infinity Fabric Frequency Timings, and then DDR Options. We'll find this new feature called DDR5 Nitro Mode, and reading the description, it says it can improve memory overclocking for models beyond 6000 MTS. So let's say you are into going beyond 6000, this Nitro feature will help you achieve higher memory frequency, but at the cost of an increased boot time and some latency trade-off. When we enable it, it can activate some memory robust cleaning and control various things intended for better memory stability. I previously tried a 7200 memory speed by using XMP profile, you can check the video here, and it worked fine even without Nitro mode. But for an increased compatibility, it may help. If yours is set to 6000 or less, it will be better off to disable Nitro mode to avoid increasing the booting time. This feature wasn't specifically introduced in this BIOS version, but roughly about 5 versions ago, so I suppose still in 2024. So now let's head over to the OC section. Here I have OC Explorer set to Expert in order to unhide some options. In the Advanced CPU configurations, going to AMD Overclocking, and then to Precision Boost Overdrive, I'd like to show my current PBO settings that I've been using for a long time and are working fine. PBO limits to motherboard, overdrive scaler to 10x for sustained high frequency. I also have boost clock override to positive 200 MHz. And as for the curve optimizer, in order to reduce the likelihood of instability during my work and stuff, I've settled with all cores at negative 20. This will be 100% stable while giving some extra higher possible frequency. We'll see how the curve shaper will be on the Ryzen 9000 CPU series. But for the 5000 and 7000 series, the curve optimizer did actually great, and I must say it has benefited me quite well. Let's exit that, and here I would like to note that in order to have a stable system, when we have curve optimizer shifting our voltage curvature, especially when the system is idle, we need to disable global C-state option found in the AMD CVS setting. This will ensure to not lower the power state in Windows enough to cause random reboots due to low voltage already. Still in the AMD CVS, if your CPU has more than one CCD and is using 3D V-Cache technology such as the 7900X3D or the 7950X3D with more than 8 cores, I usually keep my CVVC dynamic preferred cores set to auto. I avoid setting it to any of driver cache or frequency. Also, make sure to have the latest chipset driver from the AMD website, according to your chipset model, of course. This ensures you have all the latest fixes. For me personally, it has been silky smooth experience for quite some months after initially having big problems with stuttering in some games and poor performance outcome. But later on, as more BIOS versions and the chipset drivers were released, it has improved the performance quite a lot on my 7950X3D CPU. So in summary, in BIOS, just make sure to have it set on auto and ensure you have the latest chipset driver version installed. Let's go back to the main OC settings, and here we'll find the new option called Optimized Platform Profile or OPP. This one was never present before this version, and by clicking it, we can see a profile for my RAM kit saying Hynix 16GB DDR6000. So what's the difference between this and Expo? Well, we can see if we choose it and want to override the Set Expo settings, changes are almost identical. Most of the stuff are the same except for DRAM VPP voltage changing from 1.850 to 1.800 and VDD IO from 1.352 to 1.350. As for the rest, I see no difference. So I think it's an MSI specific feature, but we'll see more about this feature as we try different kits also for the next Ryzen CPUs. And when you enable the OPP, it disables the Expo option. Now we'll be comparing the booting time later on to see if there is some benefit to this option. But I also want to point out to some great feature about this motherboard, which is the high efficiency mode. The name can be a bit confusing, but by enabling it, we can see memory timing preset options. So we can tighten or loosen memory timings and ultimately gain some free performance with just one click. On my RAM setup, I was able to set it to the tighter option. I've shown you guys about it back when it was released the last year. And here is the performance gains I got, about 10% in some scenarios. So I recommend that you give it a try, and I can confirm that my system is super stable with it on. Next we have is the memory try option. This will give you some random memory profiles to try on with some generic RAM overclocking profiles, not necessarily tested with your RAM model, but just to try if it's going to work and increase some performance. More like try to win sync. Memory context restore will avoid retraining memory in some scenarios, possibly reducing booting time. And while it cuts boot time by more than 5 times better, I occasionally get blue screen of death with it, so I usually recommend having it off. Finally and most importantly, always make sure to set your CPU NB or SOC voltage to a fixed value in order to avoid any socket or CPU burn. Sure, by now most motherboards vendors has addressed this issue, but I still prefer to set mine to a fixed 1.2 volt, and it works great with my 6000 RAM setup ever since I've set it back in the last year. You can check my dedicated video about this topic in the recommended video here. And now finally, I want to compare the booting time between a BIOS of 2023 versus the newest one with Expo, and we have on the right the new optimized platform profile. Let's see if there has been any improvement to cut the memory training time for the IM5 platform with this certified Expo RAM kit. Unfortunately, as we can see, the change is non-existent. It's a disappointment that for almost 2 years since the release of the Ryzen 7000 series CPUs, there hasn't been an improvement to cut the memory training time for Expo to reduce the booting delay. 1 minute is still quite long. I would love to see an improvement soon. Hopefully we'll see if the Ryzen 9000 series will be any better in this regard. So guys, that was it for this video. I hope it was useful. You can expect that when Ryzen 9950X get released, I'll be making a configuration and optimization video on this very motherboard since it's going to be compatible with it. And then later on, we'll see if upgrading to an X870E chipset motherboard will be quite worth it on the Ryzen 9000. Finally, if you enjoyed this video, please give it a like and subscribe to the channel to stay updated on more stuff. Thanks for watching and support, and see you guys in the next one.